נתיבות שלום, ספר שמות, פרשת כי תישא, פג' רש נ"ח. Right, so the parsha, basically the main thing in the parsha is the chet ha'egel, the sin of the golden calf. So toward the end, right, it says, כי על פי הדברים האלה קראתי איתך ברית. According to these words, I made a covenant with you. ויאמר השם אל משה, כתוב לך הדברים האלה, right? So השם is telling משה, write these things, because according to these things, קראתי איתך ברית, right? איתך ברית ואת ישראל, with משה and ישראל. And it said in the מדרש תנחומה, in פרשת נוח, it says over there, לא קראת הקדוש ברוך הוא ברית עם ישראל, אלא על תורה שבעל פה, right? So they said in that מדרש, that השם have the covenant with us, only on the oral Bible.
Only on the what?
The oral Bible, the one that was transferred from mouth to ear, mouth to mouth, mouth to ear, right? The oral. Torah she'be'al peh. Right? Today, the Torah she'be'al peh basically is what we have in the Gemara. But before it was written, before the Mishnayot were written and the Gemara, everything was by oral Torah, right? That's it. The Torah she'be'al peh, only with the mouth. It was not written. שנאמר, as it says, כי על פי הדברים האלה, these words, right? קראתי איתך ברית, I made the covenant. And our sage, it says, לא כתב הקדוש הוא בתורה, למען הדברים האלה, אלא על פי הדברים. So he said, and Hashem didn't write in the Torah for these things, אלא, but על פי הדברים, according to these things. So you can translate it according to, or on the mouth of the, these things. And this is the Torah שבעל פה. And there is a change, right? There is a difference between the Torah that we know, like the Chamisha Chumashim, right? The Reshit, Shmot, Vayikra, right? All the Chamisha Chumashim. There is a big difference between them and the Oral Bible, the Gemara, the Talmud. Because when you're reading the Torah, you can read and you understand. Maybe you don't understand 100% the syntax or the chronological stories over there, because sometimes it's jumping from here to there, but there is no problem for you to understand it. But the Torah שבעל פה, קשה ללמוד בה ויש בצער ונידות, I said, like, it's very difficult to learn. There is a sorrow and a lack of sleep. ויש מבלה ומנבא לעצמו אליהם. Some people like they have been aware from learning the Gemara.
And worn out.
Worn out, yeah, worning out, yeah, exactly, thank you. He said, שאין לומד אותה, אלא מי שאוהב הקדוש ברוך הוא בכל ליבו, בכל נפשו, בכל דו. The person that learns it is the one that actually love Hashem with all his being. Because it's very easy to learn Kabbalah and the mystical thing than to learn Gemara. Very difficult to learn Gemara. And therefore, the covenant was on the Torah שבעל פה, on the oral Bible. And here it is said in the end of Parashat, in the end of Parashat Mishpatim Ne'emar, ויכתוב משה את כל דברי השם, right, that Moshe was writing everything, and he took the Sefer HaBrit, the book of the covenant, and he was reading to the people, right, to the nation. And Rashi explained in the name of the Mechilta that this parasha was actually were saying or were happening before receiving the Torah. ופירוש, so the explanation, ויכתוב משה את כל דברי השם, which means from Bereshit up to the time of Matan Torah. And according to that, we found that the Torah שבכתב, the written Torah, were until Matan Torah, it says also, Sefer HaBrit, the book of the covenant. And said, so how is it reconciled with the Midrash, with the Tanchuma, that he said that the covenant was only on the oral Bible. And now we learn that it says, right, according to the Mechilta, that it's the book of covenant is also about the Torah between Bereshit until receiving the Torah on Har Sinai. So how do we reconcile it? So in the Ramban it says, because, and after having the first covenant before receiving the Torah, we have the sin of the golden calf, and we transgress, right? We We broke the deal. Broke the covenant. And they need to renew the covenant. A new one, a new contract. A new contract with Hashem. And he says, in this new contract, that's actually on the Torah Shebaal Peh, on the oral Bible. We also learn, you know, it doesn't say it here, but many things that we had were not supposed to be.
Like what?
Like the type of the Mishkan and the sacrifices, etc. They came only because of the sin of the golden calf. It was supposed to be a different type of, serving Hashem, different type of things, but we blew it. So now Hashem needed to have something for us. So we will repent, we do tshuva, we'll fix things, etc. So the whole thing has changed. And we should say that in this covenant have two meanings. There is like an inner or internal covenant, on the same way that it says in David and Yonatan, right, in Shmuel, that v'ichrot Yonatan v'David brit ba'avato to b'nafsho, right? So the covenant between Yonatan and David, there was a covenant in his love, like he loved him like his soul, which is like an internal covenant of avat nefesh, right? Not chas v'chalila, people should think that there were like two men loving each other. This is disgusting to think about it, right? It was a spiritual thing. You can understand it, you know, that the people, for example, when they are learning in Chevruta for a time, you're developing some kind of a friendship that is very difficult to explain. And even if you don't know any details about the other person that learned with you, you always feel very close to him. And you feel obligated to him, and you feel like you can give your life if there, you know, chas v'chalila, something will happen. You become very, very good friend, Chevruta. And it's very weird because sometimes you don't develop any type of conversation with the person. You're just learning with him. But just the fact that you are together with somebody and you're learning with him, something like is happening together. That's very difficult to explain. It's different than just, you know, a bowling friend. Chevruta is something, right? So this is what happened with David and Yonatan. And also there is another covenant or type of covenant when it says in Avraham and Avimelech, the king, right? He said, certainly it was not like Brit David Yonatan. It was like an external one. It was like, as you said, like between countries. One country is strong and have a very powerful army. And the other country doesn't have a strong army, but they have lots of good resources like oil and gold. So, and there is another country that is very strong, and they are looking at the small little country with the oil. They want to conquer it. So the country with the oil can make a covenant with a strong army country to protect them. And in return, they will give them oil or whatever, right, at good prices. That's like an external covenant. They don't like them. They don't love them. They don't want to be the friend. They just need the protection. So it's give and take. But the covenant with David, this is like an internal, Brit Pnimi. They did it because they love each other. Avram and Avimelech is, again, just a covenant out of interest, a mutual interest. So the light of that, according to that, we should say, Inyan Brit Shabbat Kodesh, when it says, right, we have the covenant with Shabbat. As it said, V'shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat, right? La'asot et ha-Shabbat ledorotam v'rit olam, right? It's an infinite covenant between me and b'nei Yisrael. It's a sign, it's a mark forever and ever. So the Shabbat Kodesh, it's like the inner, the internal covenant that we have, Brit Pnimit, of love between us and Hashem. As it says in the Sefer HaKadosh Bnei Yisachar, right? And he says, Ahava b'chol lev, ahava b'chol, that we love Hashem, we love the Shabbat with all our heart, with all our soul, etc. Right? And this is the same thing with the covenant with the Torah. The covenant, the first covenant that we had before Matan Torah, indeed, they said it was not so strong in the inner one. It was not. And therefore, we transgressed it. We broke the deal. But the new contract, the new covenant was an inner one, in a pnimit. According to these things, I made a covenant with you on the Torah Shebaal Peh, the Oral Bible. He said that the one that learning only needs to put an effort and is getting worn out, etc., etc. And that's why only the one that really love Hashem learning Gemara. Right? And these two covenants, Brit Shabbat to Brit Torah, right? Nemru b'mashmut, they were saying in that meaning, in that explanation, that we should have that internal covenant that all our love is giving to it. And a Jew that is learning Torah and is wearing out, right? So besides the effort that he put about the Torah and to learn, he have another level, a special level here, that is actually, by learning Torah, this is actually the covenant with the Torah, because he's giving his heart and his love, right? In all his being, in all his existence, this is actually what we should do, to learn Torah and giving our love to Hashem, showing it by learning the Torah, learning the Gemara, right? This is how it is manifested. Because we love the Torah and we learn to learn Torah, we love it, right? And also included in Ma'amar Chazal in Kiddushim, it says, Barati Yetzera, right? Hashem created the evil inclination. He created the Torah as an antidote, as a cure. As it says in the Sefer HaTorah, right? Shetavlin HaTorah, the spice of the Torah, come against the evil inclination. But it's only when he's learning the Torah, it said, like a fire with the excitement. Because the same way the evil inclination is burning like a fire, then the tikkun of that needs to be with fire, right? Fire with fire. Right, the spice of the Torah needs to be in fire. And by the way, now I think about it, spices usually when you a little bit roast them, then you actually open their aroma, the taste. So you see, work here perfect, which means loving the Torah and getting deeper in the Torah. And this is the tikkun, this is the fix to the evil inclination. And this is the meaning of the covenant of the Torah. And we can see it, you know, I think we are the only nation that actually dancing and hugging the books. And you can see that, I don't know, maybe just me, but I think everybody have the same feeling. Every time somebody doing a Hagbaha with the Torah, everybody's looking, don't drop it, right? Everybody's like thinking about it, don't dare to drop it, right? And you see somebody that is a little bit difficult to do Agbaha, everybody's holding their head, right? Why? It's just a book. No, it's not just a book. That's the covenant with Hashem. And we don't even realize it, but it's inside our soul. That's why we're dancing and hugging the book, the Sefer Torah, right? But the covenant is on the Torah Shebal Peh, on the oral Bible. And the Maran Admor Badash Zchoto Agenu Amar, he said, the Rebbe said, that the Jew should schedule every day a shiur that he needs to really, really learn in like an hour or whatever time, 5 minutes, 10 hours, whatever, that will be very, very concentrated in the Torah. And then it will be like a tvila in the mikveh, like diving deep into the Torah, into the learning. It will be like a mikveh that purifying us. So the mikveh is purifying us in the external, right? Purifying the body. But jumping into the Torah, this is like purifying our mind, our wisdom. And that will purify our bad thought, etc. When we're learning and we're investing, really to learn with concentration. Right? And this is, it says, Nemar Brit Torah or Brit Shabbat, the Torah and the Shabbat, the both of them, right? We cannot just learn Torah and we're not keeping Shabbos. And that's why it says, and this is actually like the renew covenant. So before Matan Torah, we had a covenant with the written Torah. After the sin of the golden calf, which is in this week parsha, Hashem like renewed the covenant. But now it's even a stronger one. So Bezat Hashem, we're all going to love Hashem and learn Torah and dive deep into the Torah.
Amen.